learn about difference between hardware and software. So before starting this topic, let's have some quick recap what we have studied till now. Computer is an electronic device which is usually used for solving and processing our data. Computer used in different places for different uses. For bank, it is used for maintaining customer details, maintaining withdraw and debit money. In hospital, it is used for maintaining patient's record, diagnose disease in the patient. And in airport and railway station, it is helpful for booking tickets. So in all over the world, computer is the basic necessity now in every field. Computer is popular nowadays, we all know, because computer has some features, some quality. So there are five important qualities or features of computer. First is speed. Computer works at very high speed. The instruction provided by user to computer, computer process it, computer continuously solve it and provide output or result to user. Second is accuracy. Accuracy means whatever the instruction users are giving to computer, computer will process and will give you 100% accurate answer, 100% correct answer. Third is diligence. Diligence means computer never get tired. As computer is an electronic machine, it required electricity to complete all the tasks. So computer never get tired until you provide it electricity. Next is storage. We all know now in this full of electronic world how storage is important for us. Every single day we have some memory and we want to store for a lifelong. So storage stands for the necessary for all the people. For storing our data, we need some electronic gadgets or device. So computer stands a very perfect for it. Computer is also the best example for storing device. Now next is versatility. Versatility means when computer can perform more than one task. Suppose you are giving computer some instruction to play a music. At the same time, you can give instruction to have a video chat with some other person who is far away or other side of the globe. So versatility is the quality where it can perform more than one task at once. So computer is also a good example of versatility. Now there is a big difference between versatility and versatile. Versatility means the quality which device having to complete task at once, different task at once. And versatile, we can say to any particular device, to any one device, that device is a versatile machine. And when we are talking about versatility, that means that device is having a versatility quality. Next important quality of computer is storage. Now what is storage? Storage means to save your data for a longer period. If we're going to talk about computer storage, computer store all the data in two form, in 0 and 1, where 0 and 1 is known as binary digits. So from here, 0 and 1, computer memory representation start. 0 and 1, the combination of 0 and 1, 4 times it known as nibble. Whereas, if we talk about the combination of 0 and 1, 8 times, then it will represent 1 byte. And so on. You can see here data representation chart. Computer memory can be classified into two types. First is primary memory or main memory, or you can say internal memory also. And the second type of computer memory is external memory or secondary memory. Primary memory is again categorized into two types, that is RAM and ROM. RAM stands for random access memory. You can understand with this line. When we start the computer, operating system is loaded into RAM. Any software that we run is also loaded in RAM. It means that a computer with more RAM will work faster than computer with lesser RAM. Now, second kind of primary memory is ROM. ROM stands for read-only memory. This is a permanent electronic memory. In this, the startup instructions for the computer are stored permanently in the form of bits. That means if you are storing any data in ROM, then afterward, after some time, when you will again open it or use it, then you will not able to do editing in that program or in that document. So whatever you are storing in ROM is only known as non-volatile. Now, secondary memory is again categorized into so many parts. Some examples of secondary memory are CD, DVD, flash drive, memory card or memory stick, and etc. Now, let's talk about the difference between hardware and software, because these are the two most important components of computer. Hardware and software. Hardware is categorized into four different types, that is input device, output device, processing device and storage device. And software is categorized into application software and system software. Now let's start learning the difference between hardware and software, because the things are more clear when we get difference between two different terms. Let's start. Computer hardware refers to the physical component of computer. Computer hardware is any part of the computer that we can touch and see. These are physical electronic devices used to build up the computer. For example, hardware in computer system are the processor, memory devices, monitor, printer, keyboard and mouse and the CPU. Now, computer software. Computer software is a collection of instruction, procedure, documentation that perform different tasks on a computer system. Example, MS Word, MS Excel, PowerPoint, Google Chrome, Photoshop, etc. Now let's see the difference between hardware. Hardware is the physical component or physical part of computer system that cause processing of data. Okay, so whatever instruction you are giving to computer system, without any hardware device, you won't able to give any instruction. So hardware is important. Whereas software is a set of instruction that tells a computer exactly what to do. Means if you have given some instruction to computer with the help of hardware, now it's time to solve your problem. So here, solving your problem, software is already coded, software is already programmed, software is already installed inside the hardware. Software will do the instruction given by user. Hardware has given already instruction to software. Now it's duty of software to process it, to execute it. Next is, hardware is manufactured. Hardware is manufactured means hardware, when we have to prepare hardware, we have some installation of factory, company, some manpower we require. also hardware is prepared with the manpower in the company or some factory. When we are talking about software, it is developed and engineered. Means, so when we are going to create any software, then engineers are required. Here also manpower is required, but we are not we are not going to do some hard work. Hard work we are doing, but not physical work. Here psychologically, here mentally we are doing some coding to prepare a set of instructions. That is a software. Next is, hardware cannot perform any task without software. It's right. Hardware is nothing without software. So hardware is important as much as software is important. Without hardware, without software, the parts of computer is just a physical box, right? If we will install software inside it, then it will work. So whereas software cannot be executed without hardware, right? So this is not considered as the difference, but these are the parallel working to each other. Software is also important, hardware is also important. If we are working with hardware, it means we have the necessity to use software as well. Hardware. As hardware are physical electronic devices, we can see and touch hardware. We all know hardware is a physical device, we can see and touch. Whereas software, we can see and also use the software, but actually we cannot touch them, right? Software is installed inside the computer system, so we can see that what software is installed inside the computer system, but we cannot touch it. We cannot exactly take it from one place to another like we do with hardware. Next is, it has four main category, that is input devices, output devices, processing devices and storage devices, right? Whereas software is divided into two category, application software and system software, right? So we all know about the four types of hardware: input device, output device, processing device and storage device. Input device is what? Those devices which help us to input any data inside the computer system, which help user to give instruction to computer system. Whereas output device are those devices which help us to get instruction, to get result or to get output from the input device or the computer system. Whereas there is only one processing device, that is CPU. CPU is known as the central processing unit. It is also known as the brain of a computer. And last one is a storage device. Storage device are those devices which help user to store their data. Data can be of any type. It can be of text, image, audio, video, anything it can be. So data, those devices which help us to store any kind of data for a longer period or for a later use. These kind of devices are known as storage devices. So let's talk about software. The type of software. There are two types of software. First is system software, which is the most important software for using computer system. So if there is a software and a hardware and there is no installation of system software, then you won't able to anything, not hardware or software. So system software is important. And the second type of software is application software. Application software is what? Where you are allowed to do any specific kind of task. Let's take example about MS Word, where you can do documentation, you can do type, you can create a paper or a question paper. And the next example you can say about MS PowerPoint, where you can create a different slide with a different insert of picture or video clip or anything, any data. Now let's talk the next difference between hardware and software. Is hardware is not affected by computer virus. Now what are viruses? Viruses are that contagious body of a computer world where it will stick to your document for spoiling it, for encrypting it. Okay? Means virus एक तरह का एक body है, एक coded program है जो आपके file के साथ आपके आपके system में कहीं से भी पहुंच सकता है और आपके system में जितने भी files document है उनको धीरे धीरे spoil करता है, करप्ट करता है, ठीक है? तो हार्डवेयर को कंप्यूटर वायरस से कोई भी फर्क नहीं पड़ता है. Whereas when we talk about computer software is affected by computer virus. Yes, computer software, as I told you, virus is a program which is contagious body, which is malware, okay? Which can affect your file. Now, if you are talking about software, what is software? Software is also a set of instruction, a set of program, and both the body is located, is situated inside the hardware. Now, if virus will get to the software, virus will affect to the software, then of course it will corrupt your data as well. So, in case of hardware, virus is not affected to hardware. In case of software, virus will definitely gonna damage or spoil or encrypt your data. Next is hardware. It cannot be transferred from one place to another electrically through network. What does it mean? You cannot transfer. How can you transfer any physical component? Because physical component, we need some manpower to pick it up and keep it some other place. If we are talking about software can be transferred from one place to another. You can say one device to another. If your computer is connected in network, in some architect network, where you can transfer your any kind of software through internet connection as well. Now, if you're going to talk about hardware, if hardware is damaged, it is replaced with one new one. If your physical component of computer system can be damaged, replaced with a new one. You cannot have like a software. Now see, what is software? If software is damaged, correct? If software is damaged, its backup copy can be reinstalled. Now, what is the difference between both the terms, hardware and software, in case of damage? If hardware is damaged, we need to purchase some new hardware for using our computer system. But if we're gonna talk about software, some data or some anything can be damaged, then we have to reinstall the copy of that software. Okay? Like we are going to purchase some new software, that with that software, computer system automatically creates a copy of any software. Okay? So if that original software damage or have some corrupt data, then we are having one more option to reinstall the same software again in our device. Now, let's have some example of hardware and software. Hardware are like keyboard, mouse, monitor, printer, CPU, hard disk, RAM and ROM, etc. If we gonna talk about software, then we have MS Excel, MS PowerPoint, MS Word, Photoshop, etc. I hope both the difference between hardware and software is clear to all. Thank you very much.